those of you that don't know me, my name's Claire Carmichael. I'm a second year adult student nurse. And today I am starting a 30-day challenge. I wanted to start this challenge because I'm just genuinely unfit. I mean, I'm so skinny. If you look at my frame, I've got a tiny frame, but I am really, really unfit. I run up them stairs and I'm knackered by the time I get to the top. So I wanted to improve my own fitness levels, just get that little bit of exercise in each day where I can. And the other part of it is I'm giving health advice to patients and I'm telling them, you know, you should exercise 30 minutes a day, get your heart really going, put some work into it. And I feel like I'm a bit of a hypocrite because I'm giving this advice, but I'm not taking that on board myself. I don't look after my body. I eat well. I eat very well. I do have the odd takeaway sometimes, but all in all, I love my vegetables and fruits and I genuinely eat really well. But the exercise side of it is I'm terrible. I'm really unfit and I need to build my fitness up. So for me to give that advice to a patient and to be able to give the best care possible for my patient, I need to put myself in that patient's shoes. So I've created a 30-day challenge. I'm going to completely erase all of your excuses, everybody's excuse, even my own excuses. You know, we all say, oh, the weather's rubbish, I don't want to go outside, it's raining, I haven't got the time, I haven't got the motivation, I'm working long hours, I just haven't got enough time in the day to fit in exercise. So I'm on this 30-day challenge to show you simple, easy steps that you can do from your own home. Doesn't matter if it's raining, doesn't matter if it's sunny outside. Actually, if it's sunny outside, get in your garden and do it. So I'm just going to show you some easy things you can do, 30 minutes every single day. I'm going to show you how easy it is. If I can do it, anybody can do it because I'm genuinely unfit and you'll see that from my videos, how unfit I am, because I will be out of breath. And I just want to build awareness around it and I want to eradicate all these excuses, you know, that patients make, other students make, and I want to promote it and health advise people, and I want to be my best self so I can give this advice to patients so that when they come in to me and say, I haven't got the time, I can say, hang on a minute, you have got the time, I've tested this, I've tried it myself, we are here, you know, this is evidence-based practice going on right here, starting from today for the next 30 days, and this is what we're going to do. And the other side of it is, I didn't want to just do this for patients, for myself. I wanted to do this for some form of charity as well, because for those of you that don't know, we've got Electra Claire Flatt at Birmingham City University. She's absolutely fantastic. She's so lovely. She was sadly diagnosed with cancer, and she decided, no, this isn't going to affect me. I'm going to do something to help other people, to raise awareness, to raise money for charity. So she set up Claire's Challenge and she's raising money for the cancer charity. So from hearing that from her, I thought, what can I do? And I was been trying for ages to think of something that I can do to help the charity, to raise some money, to put something into Claire's Challenge. And so I'm gonna donate this to Claire's challenge. So I'm going to put the links below. I'm going to put all the details. I'm going to post her page, her giving page. Please donate if you can. You know, I need to be my best self for my patients. So I'm doing it for everybody. I'm a little bit nervous, I'm not going to lie. Terrible at exercise, and it's the one thing that I'm really bad at. So fingers crossed we get through this 30 days. So I'm not going to put in my whole 30 minutes exercise into this vlog because that's going to be really boring for somebody to watch. So I'm just going to video bits stage by stage and update you as I'm doing it and take some short videos and put it all together so that you can see what I'm doing. And I'm going to review it at the end and see how it went, how I feel, so you can see how I feel, how sweaty I am, horrible mess I'm sure, and let's see what happens. If anyone has stairs at home, we're going to do some running up and down the stairs because it's simple, it's easy, it's going to get your heart going. It's a great starting point, I think. There's my stairs. I'm going to run up and down now. I'm going to take you with me to start with. I'm going to do this for... I need a watch. I've got my watch. I knew this would come in handy for something else other than nursing. It's 5 to 5. I'm going to do this for 10 minutes, running up and down the stairs for 10 minutes, and we'll be back. Okay, so let's go. Thank you. I'm dead. It's actually harder than it looks. Oh my God. It's actually killing me. I'm so unfit. I'm really struggling to breathe. Is that normal? I'll be back. Why do I do these things? Wow. Okay, so 10 minutes of doing that, running up and down the stairs, and now we're gonna do some jumping jacks for 5 minutes. What have I done? This is a lot harder than it looks, guys. So I think now I'm going to show you just, because obviously there's gonna be patients that aren't so able-bodied, so they might not be able to run up and down stairs. They might not even have stairs. So I'm gonna do some exercises that suits that sort of person's needs, that sort of individual's needs, that maybe just can't do as much exercise. They just need some light exercise, mainly because I'm struggling myself. So I'm just gonna do some light exercises now, just to finish the session, the last 15 minutes. So if a patient has got some stairs but they can't run all the way up and down stairs, I would recommend just using maybe the bottom step and just doing step ups like this, just as quickly or slowly as they can, just to get maybe the heart going a little bit, just some form of exercise that they can do. And I think that's a bit easier for some patients, I think. So someone that hasn't got stairs, maybe they could just do step ups just on the floor like this. And they can go as high, they can raise their legs as high as they want, as low as they want, they can do it as quick as they want, as comfortable as possible as it is for them. Just about adjusting the needs to the individual, I think, and what they can and can't do depending on the age and the physical abilities. And they can do this for a while. So I am now outside, so anyone that has a garden, it's going to be great to exercise in the garden or your local park. So I'm just going to do a few more outside just to round the session off. Absolutely dead. So I'm gonna round that off there. 30 minutes is up. I've done my 30 minutes. Absolutely dying. I'm hoping tomorrow I'm gonna be a lot fitter. I'm not gonna improve in a day. It's that thing, you know, you do a little bit of exercise and you think, yes, I'm really good now. Look at me, I'm slim, I'm toned, I'm muscly. I'm hoping by the end of this 30-day challenge, I'm not gonna be breathless at the end of it. That's my goal right now, setting myself a goal, not to be breathless by the end of the 30 minutes, 30 days challenge. So thanks for tuning in. Anyone else wants to take part in this 30-day challenge, please jump on the wagon and do it. For now, I'm gonna chill out.